In this video segment, we'll discuss about writing VHDL code of second type of flip-flop as JK flip-flop. Now friends, in the previous segment, we have discussed about SR flip-flop, where we have seen four combinations starting from 00 up to the last 11. Now in the last combination, when the term was 11, it was undefined, that we call it as a race around condition. And this can be accomplished by converting an SR flip-flop into JK flip-flop. Ultimately, we can say the race around condition can be eliminated. Now let us come at defining the JK flip-flop. Here you can see a schematic of JK flip-flop, where as usual we have present inputs as J and K and a clock pulse. It may be positive or negative clock pulse, and we have a normal output Qn and inverted output as Qn bar. Now, as I already told you, in some of the truth tables, we can write the next state output as Qn plus 1 also. That could be fine. Now, based on this particular schematic, we can come across the input combinations where we have JK and output as Q and Qn. Now, for the first combination, when both the inputs are 0, 0, the outputs are unchanged. That means it remains same. Now, when J0 and K is equals to 1, our normal output will be 1 and inverted becomes 1. In case of 1-0 combination, normal output will be 1 and inverted becomes 0. So they are complementary to each other. And when both the combinations are 1-1, Q, that is normal output, becomes inverted and inverted becomes normal. That means they are going to be inversely or inverted to each other. This was the concept that has been revealed in case of JK flip-flop. Okay. Now based on the given truth table, let us define its VHDL code. We'll start with defining library element as IEEE. You will use this library element as IEEE.standardlogic1164. This is the standard package .org. That means we are using all the components from this particular tool. Now we'll define the entity as JK flip-flop is, with its port as JK, which is input standard logic, clock and reset as input standard logic, Q and QB as output standard logic. So Q is normal and QB is going to be complementary or inverted output. We'll end it. Now we'll come across architecture behavioral of JK flip-flop is. We'll initialize the architecture using begin statement, and for behavioral style of modeling, we'll write the process statement with the input terms JK, clock and reset. Now in order to initialize process statement, we'll write begin. Now the first condition, we have to write if RST is equals to 1. When the preset is equals to 1, then the outputs are going to be 0, 0. Now, when there is a clock change, it may be from 0 to 1 or 1 to 0, depending upon which types of clock pulse we are using, we have to check whether this condition is satisfied. So we can write else if clock is equals to 1 and clock tick event. So this condition indicates whether there is an event on clock pulse or not. Event is nothing but switching from 0 to 1 or 1 to 0. So we were at 0, so it should be from 0 to 1. If this condition is satisfied, it will return the true value and the circuit will accept the input. So in that case, we can write if J is not equals to K. This indicates not equals to K. If this condition is satisfied, Q, that is our normal output, should remain equals to J, and QB becomes not equals to J. So if J is 0, normal output will be 0 and inverted will be 1. And if J is 1, normal will be 1 and inverted will be 0. So in this way, we'll get the two combination 0, 1 and 1, 0. In last case, we'll come across else if both the inputs are 1, 1. Now if both the inputs are 1, 1, Q becomes equals to not J and QB becomes equals to J. That means simply if J is equals to 1, we'll get it here 0 and QB, that is going to be 1. So we'll get the combination as 0, 1. Now this was the condition that is called as race around condition in SR flip-flop, where we are getting the both the outputs as 0, 0, that has been eliminated using JK flip-flop. Now first we have initialized here an if statement, so we'll end if. Then we have initialized if for reset also, so we'll end this one also. Initialize process statement, so end process. And we have initialized architecture, and this is end architecture. So in this way, one can write VHDL code for JK. Thank you very much.